Hey guys, Jessica here, your furry family coach. And in this video, we're going to talk about the different ways to feed a raw diet to your dog or cat. And at the end of the video, I'm going to tell you how I choose to feed our pets. So stick with me. Hey y'all, Jessica here. And again, this video is all about the many different ways that we can feed our pets a raw diet. So let's start out by saying that any fresh food, any raw, whole, fresh foods that you can add to your pet's diet is going to make a huge difference in their health. So even if you can't necessarily afford to completely switch over to a whole food or a raw food diet, any little bit that you can add daily or even weekly is really going to help improve your pet's health. So there are a number of different ways that you can actually choose to feed a raw diet, and I have my little cheat sheet here. The first way is to feed a commercially blended raw diet, and you can find some really great companies out there. It's an up-and-coming field, so there are more and more local small businesses around the country who are creating small batch raw pre-made blends that are balanced. And anyone that you do find, I do highly recommend that you ask for proof that the meals that they are providing are balanced. It's really something that's fairly easy for them to do. They can send their recipe mixtures off to special labs. It's pretty inexpensive, and they can be tested against the AFCO requirements for balanced nutrients for dogs and cats. And just as a reminder, AFCO requirements are actually quite low. Like if there's a scale of this is excellent and this is enough to get by, AFCO's like right down here at enough to get by. So as long as they can meet AFCO standards, you're going to be doing well. If they can't even meet AFCO standards, then I wouldn't recommend buying it, or buying it and supplementing to make sure you're feeding a balanced raw diet. So commercially available is number one. The second one is a prey model. And what you're doing here is with a prey model diet is mimicking the ancestral diet of your dog or cat. So you're going to be feeding lots of bone, organ meat, muscle meat, and quite possibly even some fruits and vegetables. What it really ultimately means is that you're going to choose, in every instance possible, you're going to choose to feed whole foods rather than supplements. So you're going to feed your dog foods that provide all the vitamins and minerals they need. The third type is a whole prey diet. And I think fewer people feed this, however, it's ancestrally correct. So with a whole prey diet, you're gonna feed your pet whole, or at least, as you know, whole parts, or quite possibly the whole animal, including fur and scales and feathers, the whole shebang. You could have a very large dog and you feed them an entire chicken, or you know, a large to medium sized dog and you give them an entire rabbit to eat. So what a prey model means that you are actually feeding your dog the entirety of its prey. The fourth type is lovingly referred to as the BARF model, B-A-R-F, and that stands for biologically appropriate raw foods. So here, with a biologically appropriate raw food diet, it's very similar to the prey model diet, but we're actually going to be adding in fruits and vegetables here to supplement for the vitamins and minerals that your dog or cat would need, but primarily dog, because cats are obligate carnivores. So the fifth type of raw food diet that you may be feeding your dog or cat is a hybrid diet. And a lot of people feed the hybrid diet because you're taking bits and pieces of all these different diets, and you know, one night, or you know, one week you may be feeding whole prey, and the next week you may be feeding a BARF model diet. So you're kind of mixing and matching all the different types of raw feeding. You may even supplement with commercially available raw foods to get to feed your dog, and it's a very popular way to go, and I think it's probably one of the best ways to go because you're really getting a ton of variation. Even when I was watching a little tiny snippet of a talk that Dr. Kara Becker recently gave at the Lucas and Berube Healthy Pet Summit, and it was just a teeny, teeny, tiny little snippet, but she said, if you're going to feed commercially available raw, not only feed all the different protein variations that are available, as long as you know your dog can have all the different protein variations, but not only that, feed a bunch of different companies, because every company is going to have different macro and micronutrients in their raw blends, and the more diversity that we can give to the microbiome of our pet's gut, the healthier they're going to be. So if you are transitioning, or if you are interested in transitioning to a raw food diet, or even if you're interested in supplementing your pet's food, the commercially available kibbles and wet foods, with a raw food diet or a whole food, fresh food diet, these are some of the ways that you can do it. And I told you at the very beginning of this video that I was going to tell you how I feed my dog, and just for time, I started out a DIY hybrid kind of raw food feeding, making it myself at home, and just for time's sake, we have switched over to using currently three different commercially available brands of raw foods. That one is local here to us in San Diego, and two are available nationwide, or one is available nationwide and the other is mostly available nationwide and trying to be more available nationwide. And because this is my video, I'm going to share them with you. We feed Darwin's and we feed Answers, and our local pet company is called Maxota Raw. So we rotate all three of these, and we rotate all of the proteins that they all have available, so that Kim, our dog, is getting the best of everything, and her microbiome and her gut is constantly getting different macro and micronutrients, and we supplement a lot with the Answers fermented line of goat's milk and cheese treats, and she loves them. So with that, guys, if you have any questions, please leave them below, and I will be happy to answer them to the best of my ability. If you haven't already joined the Train Positive group, please do so. I will put a link in the description. And for all my wonderful YouTube family, please make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and you hit that subscribe button so you never miss another video. And with that, I will see you guys in the next video.